want me to say
the story, because that was just
the
funny.
The whole story?
I don't know.
I'm going to say it. There's the story of the two crazy people from Xmart. You have the crazy bitch played by some blonde woman, and then you have the meth head played by some guy that wanted to beat my brother up. I don't know. So we are standing there, and we are making jokes about the giant dildo that are shaped like fists, and we are making jokes about the tiny little Asian vibrators. So we are all having fun, yes? And then me and my group of friends, there is five of us, that is Cody and Ashley and Rebecca and Laura and Erica. And we all get separated, and I'm standing there with my brother, and I'm like, oh, you want a GG? Yeah. He's like, I have no idea what a GG is. Erica, it's halfway across the room. I say, Erica, do you know what a GG is? And she's like, GG's a whore, yes? And the other customers are laughing, right? Yes, they're laughing because it's hilarious.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm dancing. It's funny. It's not a problem. We continue on. 5 seconds later, blonde bitch, played by the blonde, he's like, oh, we are all adults here. This is an adult store. We do not need to be yelling like little children. And I'm like, if you do not want me to yell like little children, do not speak to me as if I am a child. So I'm like, yeah. But I keep this thought to myself because I do not want to cause conflict, yes?
Yes.
So, this is a good plan. So, I'm like, okay. And my brother's like, bitch. And I'm like, bro, just leave it alone. He's like, okay, fine, I'll leave it alone. So, we all decide we're going to leave. Laura bought something for them. Oh, yes. But she was paying for it. And me and Erica go outside, mostly so I could tell a story. And other reason was I didn't want to confront the little blonde bitch about being a bitch to me. So here we are waiting outside, and then my brother comes storming out, and I'm like, oh, it's not good, it can't be good. And so I have to hear the story, and the story is, I leave, and then the meth head, played by the meth head, is all like, you, that girl in the red bandana, that was me, I was loud apparently. He was all like, does that bitch ever know how to shut her fucking mouth? And he's telling this to my brother. This is not good plan. My brother is going to be pissed. My brother is like, it is free country. And the other guy goes nuts and is like, spit it out. Now, this is all from hearing it from third person, so I wasn't really there. But I'm sorry, you just don't look at people and say, spit it out. Because when they spit on you, you'll be pissed.
Especially in an adult store. It could be cool.
Exactly. It could be calm, and that's no good. It's not very becoming to come on your face. But anyway, this is not part of the story. I was not, well, this is part of the story, but not that, anyway, I'm getting off track. So my brother's all like, didn't even say anything. And the guy got pissed and was like, you need to leave my store, even though it's not his store, but he made him leave. So my brother's like, fine, and my brother leaves. And this is where he storms out, and I'm like, oh, brother, what happened? And he's like, oh, okay. It starts telling me the story. Crazy meth head comes running out of the store, and he is like, fuck. That's mostly all I understood. It's fuck out the store. You don't need to be here ever again. I don't want to see you. Lots of effort. Lots of goddamn. Lots of not good. Not good things to say to customers, right? So I'm like, okay, this can't be good. So I'm standing there and I'm waiting. I still have two friends inside. This is Rebecca and Laura. And I'm like, oh, they bought the nice thing for tea and it was great. But they bought this thing and they're trying to leave. And the meth head decides he is done ranting. And he goes back to the store and Rebecca and Laura are leaving. So he opens the door like a gentleman. And we are laughing because that's stupid. I'm going to open the door for you because we're running the beach. Okay, so I'm standing here, and later I hear the woman inside is still bitching at me, about me. And I'm like, I didn't do anything. They have customers complain about me? These customers were laughing last time I heard. You mean, who's going to complain in a sex store anyway, right? I mean, think about this. This is not good. And I'm like, okay,
good.
Well, that's key. What the hell? I mean, really, I don't know how to end this story. How do I end this story?
You said the end.
Oh, okay, the end.